Hola, kindergarten and first grade. This is Señora Baez again, and welcome to Spanish class. Okay, the focus, the main focus, or enfoque central of today's class. We're going to do our intro song and review our vocabulary words. We're going to review new words. We're going to go over the alphabet and the vowels. We're going to listen to a short story about a ratón, a mouse. And do a cierto or falso activity. We'll talk about mascarillas. And then we are going to listen to fun facts about our country study. ¿Listos? Ready? We have hola, adiós, amigos, hello, goodbye, friends, mariposa, yo, buenos días, buenas tardes. Buenas noches. We have Coca-Cola. We have me llamo, or my name is. Then we have, ¿qué te pasa, calabaza? What's wrong, pumpkin? Nada, nada, limonada. Nothing, nothing, lemonade. Mira, look. Y escucha, listen. So let's do the song. ¿Listos? Okay. Hola, hola, Coca-Cola. Adiós, amigos. Buenos días, buenos días. Buenas tardes, buenas tardes. Buenas noches, buenas noches. ¿Cómo estás? How are you? Mira, mira, mira. Escucha, escucha. Levanta la mano. Raise your hand. Shh. No, hable. No talking. There we go. Camina, camina. Walking, walking, walking. Corre, corre, corre. Running, running, running. Salta, salta, salta. Jump. Piensa, piensa, piensa. Think, think, think. Mascarilla, face mask. Okay, so how can we describe ourselves? Let's first say our name. Everybody say it with me. Let's say it together. But first, I'm going to give you an example. My name is Claudia or Claudia. So I'm going to say, yo me llamo Claudia. My name is Claudia. One more time. Yo me llamo Claudia. Now say it with your name. Yo me llamo. Say your name. One more time. Yo me llamo. Good. Let's review our characters. Let's say our names like we're this guy. Yo me llamo Hulk. Yo me llamo Iron Man. Yo me llamo Yoda. Yo me llamo Spider-Man. Yo me llamo Batman. Now let's have a brain break. Oh. Up, down, arriba, abajo. Up, down, arriba, abajo. Stand up and dance. Up, down, shake it all around. Up,
shake, shake it all around. Arriba, abajo, mueve tu cuerpo. Arriba, abajo, así. Arriba, abajo, mueve tu cuerpo. Arriba, abajo, así. Side, side, jump to the side. Side, side, jump to the side. Side, side, jump to the side. Jump, jump, jump to the side. Salta, salta, salta al lado. Salta al lado, así. Salta, salta, salta al lado. Salta tres veces, así. Spin around, spin yourself around. Spin, spin, spin yourself around. Spin around, spin yourself around. Spin, spin, spin yourself around. Cuenta, cuenta, dame una cuenta, dame una cuenta, así. Cuenta, cuenta, dame otra cuenta, dame otra cuenta, así. Up, down, shake it all around. Up, down, shake it all around. Up, down, shake it all around. Shake, shake, shake it all around. Arriba, abajo, one, two, one. Arriba, abajo, así. Arriba, abajo, one, two, one. Arriba, abajo, así. Hey, this is Basho. Thanks for coming to the channel. I hope you enjoyed that video. If you want to see last week's video, just click over here. And please do subscribe. Hit the button down below. I hope to see you again soon. Later. Up, down, shake it all around.
Okay, now we're going to go over the alphabet. I want you guys to remember, this is the alphabet in Espanol, in Spanish. It's different to the alphabet in English, but it is almost the same letters. There's only two different letters. So when they're saying the alphabet in Spanish, it helps you know the letters in English because they're putting them in a different color. Okay, so pay attention, and I will ask us to repeat some of these letters together. ¿Listos? Ready?
El alfabeto, the alphabet, el alfabeto. A, B, C, G.
A, B, C, G.
D, E, F, G.
D, E, F, G.
H, I.
H, I.
J, K.
J, K.
L, E,
L, E.
M, N.
M, N.
N, O, P, Q. S-T-U-E
W-E
W-E
E-T-S
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 Z-T-S
Z-T-S
A-B-C-C
A-B-C-C
E-E-F-G
Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is we are going to repeat the first five letters, okay? A, B, C, D, and E. Let's do them in Espanol. A, B, C, D, E. One more time. A, B, C, D, E. Muy bien. Now we're going to go over the vowels, las vocales. Repeat after me. A, E, 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 E is I. E is the letter I. O, O, letter O, and U, U is U. Okay, so let's read these letters that start with la letra A. Árbol. Árbol means tree. Andes. Andes, mountains. Andes, agua, water. Palabras con E, words with E. Escoba, escoba. Espejo, espejo. Entrenar, entrenar. Entrenar is to train. Espejo is mirror. And escoba is a broom. Igloo, igloo. Invierno, invierno. Iglesia, iglesia. What season is invierno? Invierno is winter. What is an iglesia? Is where people go to pray. It is called a church. Igloo is an igloo. An igloo. Palabras con O. O. Once. This number, 11. Once. Oveja. Oveja is a sheep. Oscuro. Oscuro means dark. Dark. Palabras con U. Palabras con U. Words with U. Unicornio. Unicornio. Uniforme. Uniforme. Uniform. Universidad. University or college. Universidad. Okay. Let's look at this picture. So, remember how we did with our lives? Cierto means true. Falso means false. Okay, one more time, say it with me. Cierto means true, falso means false. So let's look at this picture. We have a woman, she is wearing a coat and a stethoscope. This is how they listen to your heartbeat. She's wearing scrubs and work shoes. So let's see if we can answer these questions. True or false? Cierto or falso? ¿Es profesora? ¿Es profesora? What do you guys think? ¿Es profesora? She a teacher? Like Señora Baez? What do you think?
Falso.
Whoops. So let's look at the questions. The first one says, ¿Es una profesora? Oh, we already answered that. It's falso. She's not a teacher. ¿Trabaja en un hospital? Hospital. Does she look like she works in a hospital? Possibly. Cierto. Lleva una bata blanca. Does she look like she's wearing a white coat? Cierto or falso? Cierto. Su trabajo es curar animales. This one's a tricky one. Does she look like she could be helping animals get better? We don't really know. And vets, veterinarians, do wear stethoscopes. So, cierto. Es médica. Cierto. She could be a medic or a doctor. Ahora vamos a escuchar el ratón que se comió la luna. We're going to listen to the story, The Mouse That Ate the Moon. El ratón que se comió la luna.
Hola niños, mirad qué libro tan bonito tengo aquí. El ratón que se comió la luna. El ratón que se comió la luna. Una noche, un ratoncito se asomó por el pequeño agujero en el que vivía y vio la luna. ¡Qué bonita es la luna! Pensó el ratoncito mientras se metía en la cama. Me encantaría tener un pedacito. Mañana siguiente, cuando el ratoncito se levantó, vio algo que nunca había visto antes. ¡Ha caído un pedazo! exclamó. ¡Mi deseo se ha hecho realidad! El ratoncito salió corriendo y se acercó a la luna. Olía deliciosamente. Quizás se pueda comer, pensó el ratoncito. Huele tan bien. Solo le daré un mordisco. Comió un bocadito y otro y otro y uno un poco más pequeño. Hasta que... se hubo comido la mitad de la luna. ¡Bueno! Pensó el ratoncito. Ahora la luna nunca volverá a ser redonda. ¿Qué te pasa, ratoncito? Le preguntó el conejo. Me he comido la mitad de la luna, respondió el ratoncito. Y ahora nunca volverá a ser redonda. Nadie puede comerse la luna, dijo el conejo. Pues yo me la he comido, contestó el ratoncito. Pasó delante de la casa del topo. ¿Qué te pasa, ratoncito? Preguntó el topo. Me he comido la mitad de la luna, dijo el ratoncito. Y ahora nunca volverá a ser redonda. Nadie puede comerse la luna, dijo el topo riéndose. Pues yo me la he comido, contestó el ratoncito. El ratoncito volvió a su madriguera y miró tristemente lo que quedaba de la luna. Empezaba a oscurecer. Entonces oyó al conejo y al topo, que le llamaban. ¡Ratoncito, sal de tu agujero! Gritaron. ¡Queremos enseñarte algo! El ratoncito acompañó al conejo y al topo hasta lo alto de la colina. Se sentaron y miraron el cielo estrellado. Y entonces algo brillante apareció detrás de los árboles. ¡Era la luna! ¡Grande y redonda! El ratoncito estaba contentísimo. ¡Mirad la luna! Gritó. ¡No me la he comido! El conejo, el topo y el ratoncito se sentaron y se comieron la otra mitad de la luna del ratoncito bajo las estrellas. Estaba deliciosa y la gran luna iluminaba el cielo, porque la verdad es que nadie puede comerse la luna.
Okay, so let's talk about the story. We had un ratoncito. Ratón means mouse. Ratoncito is little mouse. Y la luna. La luna is the moon. And here he is. And he lived in un agujero, a little hole. Vio la luna. He saw the moon.
Noche.
He said, "Qué bella es la luna." The moon is beautiful. He said, "Me encantaría tener un pedacito." He would love to have a piece of la luna, the moon. La mañana siguiente, the next morning, when he woke up, he saw something he had never seen before. He said, ha caído un pedazo de luna. He said, a piece of the moon has fallen from the sky. My wish has come true. Do you guys think that's true? Piensa. He said, maybe puedo comerlo. Maybe I can eat it. So he opened it and took a mordisco, a bite. Comió un bocadito y otro. y otro, and another bite, and another bite, and another bite. Until he ate half of la luna, half of the moon. Oh no, ahora la luna nunca volverá a ser redonda. Now the moon won't be round anymore. Do you think that's cierto or falso? ¿Qué te pasa, ratoncito? What is wrong, mouse? Asked the bunny. He said, I've ate la mitad de la luna. I ate half of the moon. And it will never be redonda again. It won't be round again. Then he goes to the anteater. El topo dice, ¿qué te pasa, ratoncito? He asks, what's wrong, little mouse? Me he comido la mitad de la luna. I've eaten half of the moon. The anteater said, no one can eat the moon. And the mouse said, I've ate the moon. Do you think that's cierto or falso? He goes back to his agujero, where he lives. And he looks very sad to la luna, to the moon. Then, el topo y el conejo told him, get out of your hole, sal de tu agujero. And they went with him on a walk where he sees la luna, bella y redonda. The moon is round and beautiful. He did not eat the moon. What did he eat? Una banana. The next story we are going to listen to is called Buenas Noches, Gorila.
Buenas noches, gorila. Por fin y más. Buenas noches, gorila. Buenas noches, gorila. Buenas noches, elefante.
Good night, elephant.
Buenas noches, león.
Good night, lion.
Buenas noches, hiena. Buenas noches, jirafa.
Good night, giraffe. Good night, hyena.
Buenas noches, armadillo. Buenas noches, querido. Buenas noches. Buenas noches.
All of the animals followed the zookeeper home. Buenas noches.
Buenas noches. Buenas noches. Buenas noches, zoológico. Buenas noches, querido. Buenas noches.
El gorila.
Buenas noches, gorila.
Está en la cama con el del zoológico. El fin, the end. The next part of our lesson is Where in the world is Señora Baez going? A Mexico, to Mexico. We are going to a town called Teotihuacan. Let's say that together. Teotihuacan. It is in Mexico, and it is an area where there are pyramid ruins built by the Aztecs. The Aztecs. They were the Native Americans that lived in Mexico. And these are the pyramids that they built. We're going to watch a short video about some kids who visited Teotihuacan.
Today we're in Teotihuacan. This is where our video is set and what we're going to be learning about. We're about 40 miles outside Mexico City, and you can see a pyramid in the background, but right behind me. Well, not right behind me, but behind me.
Hay muchas escaleras. There's lots of steps to climb up the mountains.
Our first small temple is the Citadel. The Citadel, ancient ceremonial center, is the shape of a square of 400 meters long on each side. This is the Temple of the Feathered Serpent, aka Quetzalcoatl. This is the third largest pyramid at Teotihuacan. From the Citadel, you can see the two larger pyramids in the background. Now we are walking on the Avenue of the Dead. It was named by the Aztecs because they thought the mounds on the sides looked like tombs. We found the secret passage. Archaeologists have tried to find the underground rooms for years, and it looks like so cool! Another secret passage! Let's go in again! I think this is a big win for science. Here's more of the tombs on the side of the avenue. So, now I have passed through the Avenue of the Dead. And next, I'm going to find the Pyramid of the Moon. But the famous Pyramid of the Sun. The big one on the right is the Pyramid of the Sun. We first climbed the smaller one on the left. Look at this view from the top of the Pyramid of the Moon. You can see the whole Avenue of the Dead and the giant Pyramid of the Sun. There she is, 230-foot Pyramid of the Sun.
We're gonna climb this whole thing! I am so scared!
The Pyramid of the Sun was constructed in about the year 200. That is about 1,800 years ago. It is the largest pyramid here. I hope I can make it. Halfway up, water break! We're at the top of the Pyramid of the Sun, and now I have made it! Look at these spectacular views over all of Teotihuacan. Even the Pyramid of the Moon looks small from up here. Enjoy the view, people! I am checking out a ruined apartment complex. Come in and let's check it out. Uh-oh, dead end. Let's check out tomorrow. The government made people live in these apartments so they have better control over their lives. That's me. Teotihuacan is great. I hope you have a good time when you go. This is Teotihuacan and we love it. If you like this video and you learned something, be sure to click subscribe. subscribe and like below this video and watch all my other videos.
That is all for Mexico and Teotihuacan. I hope you guys don't forget, usa una mascarilla. Adiós, amigos.